Have you ever wondered why some site owners are able to hire great writers who help them rank and drive lots of traffic to their sites, while some of us struggle with the content quality produced by our writers? Is it because they pay a lot of money and that's why they get good quality content? The answer is no. In most cases, even if you pay a premium, you may not get what you want. So how do those site owners hire great writers? The secret lies in the content brief. If the writers you hire do not know what you're expecting from them, how would they know what would satisfy you? So in this video, I will share with you a guide on how to create content briefs. Let's go. Hey, it's Jack from RankMath, the one SEO plugin that empowers millions of WordPress users. And this channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. So if you're new to us, subscribe. Anyway, what exactly is a content brief? Just like going into a battle or starting a new project, other than yourself as the leader, you will be managing others. If you do not give a brief and the details on what the project is about and what it is trying to achieve or the battle plan, how would you expect your people to follow, right? So a content brief is just like the battle plan. It outlines the key elements and requirements for a piece of content, serving as a roadmap for creators. It includes everything that is expected in the content, such as the content's objective, its target audience, key messages, format, and any specific guidelines or expectations. If you want the content to lead to a sale or promotion of a product, the angle of the content needs to be discussed in the content brief. You don't want your writers to write blindly without any objectives. It would just be wasting money and resources. So let's talk about the steps to create a clear and concise content brief. Let's assume that your company sells home theater sound systems and it has just partnered with a company that sells wireless earbuds. Your partner has asked you to promote one of their products called Soundbite Pro Wireless Earbud, and you need to brief your writers on what to write about. And after some research, you've decided to work on the content targeting the keyword best budget wireless earbuds. The first thing you need to include in a content brief is the content objective. To decide on the objectives, you need to understand the purpose of the content. We know we need to promote Soundbite Pro, but is that all? What about our business? We also need to take into consideration your audience's needs. People searching for best budget wireless earbuds want affordable yet reliable options. So I would say that the primary objective is to introduce Soundbite Pro as a high-quality, budget-friendly option, but the secondary objective is to give the audience an impression that our company is a sound system expert. On top of that, your content should help your audience compare features, weigh pros and cons, and ultimately see Soundbite Pro as the best choice. And finally, your objectives should also include a call to action. Should they click a link to buy the earbud, sign up for a discount, share the article? A strong content objective always includes a call to action. And since we are promoting our partners' business, we need to protect our interests as well, right? So why not have our audience sign up to our newsletter to get a discount to buy Soundbite Pro? It benefits both our businesses. So your content brief needs to be clear on the direction and the angle, otherwise your writers wouldn't know what you're expecting. Now, if you don't know where to get started brainstorming the content objectives, leverage AI, like RankBot. On your dashboard, hover over RankMath SEO and click on Content AI. From here, click on the chat tab, and here's where you can chat with RankBot, which is trained to perform SEO tasks. You can describe the scenario you're in, such as my company sells home theater sound systems and it has partnered with a company that sells wireless earbuds. Our partner has asked us to promote one of their products called Soundbite Pro Wireless Earbud. So I have decided to write a piece of content targeting the keyword best budget wireless earbuds. While I need to promote the product, I need to look after my company's image and interests. Provide me with a list of primary and secondary objectives for the content brief so that my writers know the direction and angle of the content. The objectives should be clear and concise. Give it a while. And here we go. We have clear and concise content objectives to be included in the brief. Of course, this is not final. The AI can't read your mind, but at least this can be a great starting point for you. Now, once you've decided on the content objectives, the next step is for you to decide on the target audience. This step allows your writers to create content that resonates with the target audience. Think about why would anyone search for the keyword best budget wireless earbuds? The logical answers are students and young professionals who just came to the workforce and they're between the age of 18 to 35. This should be straightforward. However, the pain points may not be so apparent, so we can chat with the AI again. Now, feel free to ask the AI to provide you with a target audience as well. You can say, who are the target audience and what are their pain points for people searching for the keyword best budget wireless earbuds? Give it a while. And here we go. The target audience are even more precise and they have included the pain points for each group of people. And after reviewing the output, I think the AI has hit the nail. Once you have defined your target audience and have included their pain points in a content brief, the next thing you need to do is subjective to the topic. So for our topic, we are promoting a product. So we need to share with our writers how the product solves the target audience's pain points. We can include something like this in a content brief, like the sound quality, battery life, its weight, and other features. Alright, the next thing you need to do is some groundwork for your writers. Don't leave this to the writers to do it for you. It is important that you perform the next step to have control over the flow of the content. Other than the primary keyword, which is best budget wireless earbud, we need to help your writers identify secondary keywords to include in the content. You can easily find secondary keywords using tools like Google Keyword Planner. So once you are on the tool, you can click on Discover New Keywords. From here, you can add your primary focus keyword. For us, it will be best budget wireless earbuds. And then if your target audience is worldwide, you want to click on the country and remove any selected countries or regions. And in our case, Soundbite Pro ships worldwide, so this aligns. But if your content targets a specific country or region, feel free to add them accordingly. For now, let's hit save, and you will see that all locations have been selected. And now you want to click get results. From here, Google Keyword Planner will provide you with a list of keywords that are related to your primary keyword. The best is to select long-tail keywords as your secondary keywords, such as best Bluetooth earbuds under $100, then best budget noise-canceling earbuds, following that, best value wireless earbuds, etc. Because most of the time, when you target long-tail keywords, your content will inherently target those short-tail keywords. For example, in this case, best value wireless earbuds. When you target this long-tail keyword, you will naturally be targeting this best value earbuds because the long-tail keyword contains words in the short-tail keyword. Another tool I want to recommend is WordStream's Keyword Tool because it is one of the most accurate tools available for free. We did a comparison video on the best free keyword research tools, and if you're interested in checking it out, the video is right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, let's add the focus keyword to the tool and click on Find My Keywords. From here, you want to select the options that suit your needs and hit Continue. Give it a while. And you will get a list of keywords as well. And the good thing about this is that they put the most relevant keywords at the top. Plus, the search volume is more defined than what you see in the Google Keyword Planner. From here, you want to select between 3 to 5 keywords as the secondary keywords. One more tool that is useful for your keyword strategy and later your content outline is the Content AI's research tool. Now, if you have a Content AI subscription, you want to go to the post where the content will be published, and then right at the top, you want to click on the Content AI tab, and you will immediately see the research tool. You want to enter the primary focus keyword, select your target location, and hit research. And now, Content AI will scrape the top results that rank for the keyword, analyze what works for those content, and it will provide you with smart suggestions. It will tell you what is the recommended word count range based on what they have analyzed. This is key information for your writer and it needs to be included in the content brief. The same goes for the number of internal and external links. Then the heading count, the number of images and videos to include, the main keywords and the related keywords that should be used in the content, in the headings, the SEO title, and description. Following that, the questions that your content should answer, this can be added to your content outline, And finally, the recommended external links that your content should link to. This really depends on the topic. Sometimes you will not see any link recommendations because based on its analysis, there aren't any credible links. And if there are link recommendations, you can be assured that those links are only from credible sources. The thing is, you do not want your writers to have external links to sources that are not credible, because if your site links to questionable sources, it may have adverse effects on your site's SEO. Anyway, on top of the keywords and important information, you also want to provide a content structure and outline to your writers. That way, you won't have any surprises and the content quality is almost guaranteed. Now, you can either brainstorm the outline or use our blog post outline too. On your dashboard, hover over RankMath SEO and click on the Content AI module. From here, you will see the blog post outline too. Let's do an example. Let's include the topic, which is best budget wireless earbuds. Then if you have brainstormed some main points and ideas, you can add it here. But personally, I prefer to have the AI do the work, so I'll leave this field empty. Then you can select your target audience, such as students and young professionals. But since young professionals is not in the list, let's customize it. And hit comma or tab, and a tag will be created. Next, you can add the secondary keywords you have researched. Make sure to only add keywords you think are suitable in the headings. If not, feel free to leave it empty. And then the tone should follow your usual brand voice. This is subjective, but for this case, I will make it friendly. I do not see trustworthy in the list, so I will customize it. And then knowledgeable. Next, for the style, let me sidetrack a little and we'll get back to this. The goal of this step is to identify what type of content your writers should focus on. For example, we should go to Google or Bing to search for the primary focus keyword, and the first thing you see are ads. And this is implying that this keyword has commercial value. Then look out for any featured snippets, knowledge graph, AI overviews, and any other rich results right at the top. If you see AI overviews or featured snippets right at the top, like in this case, Google is telling you that your content should be informational and provide concise and clear answers. And then you want to read the SEO titles of those ranking at the top to have an idea what type of content your writer should create. In our case, we see 5 best budget and cheap wireless earbuds, which signals a listicle article, and then best wireless earbuds 2025. If we visit the content, let's read a little, and you can see that it's actually a listicle as well. And then let's go back and check this out. It is a listicle as well, as you can see from the table of contents. So as you read the SEO title and visit the content, it will give you a clear direction on the style of the content. And in this case, it should be in a listicle style. If you want to understand more about how to do SERP analysis, feel free to check out this video right here. The link is in the description. Anyway, back to the blog post outline too. For the style, we know that it should be a listicle article. And if your SERP analysis gives you another indication, you can select one of the other styles here, or you can customize it. And finally, select the language. Let's hit generate, give it a while, and here we go. If you are not happy with the output, feel free to hit generate more, and it will provide you with more alternatives. And if you are happy with this output, you can hover over it and click copy and paste it in your content brief. Take note of the heading hierarchy. Your page title should by default be the H1 heading tag, and then the H2 headings such as this, as well as this, they are headings that support or help explain your H1 heading. And then the H3 heading tags help support the H2 heading tags, which in this case are the brand models, as you can see. And if you have H4 heading tags, they are supporting titles for the H3 heading tags they are in. For example, these 4 H4 heading tags support or talks about brand A model X, and then these other H4 heading tags talks about or support brand B model Y. The same goes for this. Do not skip the hierarchy, which means never have a H3 heading tag without a H2. You see, this is H1 and immediately it jumps to H3. We should have a H2 that wraps the H3 heading tag. Or you should never have a H4 without a H3. For example, this. We have a H2 here and it immediately jumps to H4. We should have a H3 in between first. I hope this is easy for you to understand. Finally, it is important to have a list of internal links your writers should include in the content. Every internal link you have between your pages builds your site structure and helps search engines understand what your site is about. So having your writers include relevant internal links is super important. You should only provide relevant, the keyword is relevant, internal links to your writers. For example, our content is best budget wireless earbuds. The logical internal links would be Soundbite Pro review. And then if you have a comparison article such as Soundbite Pro versus Apple AirPods Pro 2, you want to provide it to your writer. And then if you have covered topics like wireless earbuds buying guide, you want to add that to the content brief as well. You need to know your content inventory well so that you can carefully build your site structure one page at a time. Now, a completed content brief will look something like this, where it includes everything that we have just talked about. Feel free to pause this video to have a careful look at it. And that's how you can create content briefs so that your writers can create high quality content. If you have any questions or suggestions, feel free to let us know in the comments down below. And don't forget to smash that thumbs up. Our channel is all about helping you grow your search traffic. And if you haven't subscribed to us yet, consider doing so. This is Jack from RankMath. I'll see you in the next video.